Hello children, welcome. This is Rajni ma'am. Today I'm starting the class 6 standard subject mathematics. This is unit 3 continuation. The unit name is playing with numbers. The next subheading of this unit is test of divisibility. Test of divisibility means we'll test the number whether it is divisible by which table. Okay, the different numbers will be given. We'll test it. The given number is divisible in which table? Okay, the test of divisibility. For the given number, we will check or test whether it is divisible by other numbers. So we get the remainder as zero. Is test of divisibility. Okay, is the test of divisibility for the given number, whatever the number is given, whether it is divisible by other numbers or other tables. So when we divide, we should get the remainder here zero. Then it is called test of divisibility. We are checking the given numbers so that when we divide, it is divisible. So the remainder we get should be zero. It is called test of divisibility. So we'll go to the example. You'll come to know example. Test whether 4 is divisible by 2. In 2 table 4 comes, 4 is divisible. Yes, that is 2 into 2 is 4. So when you divide 4 by 2, we are getting remainder 0. That is, when we divide 4 by 2, 2 into 2 is 4. So the remainder we get is 0. So for different numbers, we have different test of divisibility. Okay, so we go through the each of them. Okay, divisibility by 2. If a number is divisible by 2, if it has any of the digits, that is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 in its ones place, then it is divisible by 2. Okay, the numbers may be given. So we'll check in the ones place. Whatever the number is given, we'll check in ones place. If one place the numbers 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 is there, then that whole number is divisible by 2. Okay, we'll go to the example, then you'll come to know the example. Here the given first number is 2410, that is 2410. Here last digit, that we'll see in ones digit. In ones digit it is 0. 0. So 0 means it is divisible by 2. Next number if you take, that is 4362, that is 4362. Here last digit is 2, so 2 is divisible by 2. Yes, 2 into 1 is 2. Next number if you take, that is 1354, that is 1354. The last digit, that is in ones place, which number is there? That is 4. There's 4 is divisible by 2. That is 2 into 2 is 4. Next number, 2978. For the given number, that is 2978. The last digit, that last digit means in ones place. In ones place it is 8. Yes, 8 is divisible by 2. Yes, that is 2 into 4 is 8. Next number, 5976. The last digit, that is in ones place, it is 6. 6 is divisible by 2, yes. 2 into 3 is 6. So, the test of divisibility by 2 is, we'll check the digit we'll check the digit in ones place. If in ones place the numbers are 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8, then the whole number is divisible by 2. Or you can say that for the given number, the last digit or in ones place, if the number is even, then it is divisible by 2. Okay. If a number is divisible by 2, if it has any of the digits, that is digit which, that is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, then whatever the next number may be, the whole number is divisible by 2. The examples are 2410, next is 4362, next is 1354. Next is 2978. Next is 5976. In each set, we can see that the last digit, for first is 0, the next is 2, then afterwards the third one is 4, the next is 8, and the next is 6. In each that group set, we can see that the last digit, that is in ones place, the numbers are 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Means that all numbers are divisible by 2. This was a divisibility by 2. The next one, divisibility by 3. Means the given number, it is divisible in 3 table or no. We'll check it. For the given number, how we'll check it, okay? For the given number, if the sum of the digit is multiple of 3, then the number is divisible by 3. Okay, for the given, the number may be given, that is 21. This is a smaller number. We know that it is divisible in 3. So for the bigger number, how we'll do? So we'll check it. So for the given number here, it is 21. So if we add it, that is the both the numbers, if we add, that is 2 plus 1. 2 plus 1 is 3. We'll get the answer 3. Here 3 is multiple of 3. Yes. 3 into 1 is 3. Yes. So when you add that number, we get the answer. That answer should be multiple of 3. Then the whole number is divisible by 3. Yes, the given number is here 21. If we add it, 2 plus 1, we'll get the answer 3. Yes, 3 is multiple of 3. Then whole number. If we are getting answer 3, then 3 is multiple of 3. If 3 is, the answer is multiple of 3, then whole number is divisible by 3. That is 21. 21 is divisible by 3. 3 sevens is 21. This was for the smaller number. Okay, next example will go. So the next example is 36 here. So if we add it, the number should be divisible, that the number should be multiple of 3. Then the whole number will be divisible by 3. So we'll check it. The given number is here 36. So we'll add it. We'll add both the numbers. That is 3 plus 6. 3 plus 6 is 9. Yes, 9 is multiple of 3. Yes, 3 threes is 9. So 9 is multiple of 3. Then whole number, that is 36, is divisible by 3. For the given number, if we add both the numbers, we'll get the answer. That answer should be multiple of 3. If the answer is multiple of 3, then whole number is divisible by 3. So here 36 is a given. If we add it 3 plus 6, the answer is 9. Here 9 is a multiple of 3. Yes, 3 threes is 9. So the whole number, that is 36, is divisible by 3. Okay, this was for 2 digit. So if we come to 3 digit, that is the given number, third one, it is 219. So this whole number, if we add it, so that is 2 plus 1 plus 9. We are getting answer, that is 12. Here 12 is multiple of 3. Yes, that is 4 threes is, sorry, that 3 fours is 12. So in 3 table, here 2 is a multiple of 3. 3 fours is 12. So when the answer 12 is multiple of 3, then whole number, that is 219, is divisible by 3. If the number is not multiple of 3, then it is not divisible by 3. So for the given number, when you add all the numbers, you will get the answer. That answer should be multiple of 3. Then whole number will be divisible by 3. Here the third one is what? 219 it is. So when you add it, 2 plus 1 plus 9, we are getting answer 12. Here 12 is multiple of 3. Yes, 3 fours is 12. So when 12 is multiple of 3, then whole number, that is 219, is divisible by 3. Okay, this was divisibility by 3. Next we come to the divisibility by 4 it is. Okay, the given number is divisible by 4 or no, we'll check it. For the given number, a number with 3 or more digit is divisible by 4. The number is given, the number with a 3 or more digit is divisible by 4. How it is divisible? If the number formed by its last 2 digits, that is in 1's and 10's place. We'll check in 1's and 10's place and we'll come to know whether it is divisible by 4 or no. Okay. For the given number, a number with a 3 or more digit is divisible by 4. If the number formed by its last 2 digit, that that is one sign tens place is divisible by 4. So we'll go to the example, then you'll come to know. First example, that is 212. First example is here 212, that is 212. So to check whether it is divisible by 4, we'll check last two digit. Last two digit means that the last two digit is ones place and tens place. Okay, in ones place it is 2, in tens place it is 1. So last two digit we'll check, that is ones and tens place. The last two digit is here 12. So 12 is divisible by 4. Yes, 4 3 is 12. When last two digit is divisible by 4, then whole number will be divisible by 4. So last two digit 12 is divisible by 4, then 212 is also divisible by 4. Okay, for divisibility by 4, we'll check last two digit. That last two digit is divisible by 4, then whole number will be divisible by 4. The given number is here 212, that is 212. We'll check last two digit, that is last two digit means that is ones place and tens place. We'll check ones place and tens place. If we take, that is 12. Here 12 is divisible by 4. Yes, 4 into 3 is 12. So 212 is also divisible by 4. If last two digit is divisible by 4, then whole number is divisible by 4. This was first example. Next we come to the second example. Here it is 4 digit numbers. So for 4 digit numbers, we'll check the last two digit. Last two digit means that the numbers in ones place and tens place. In ones and tens place, what is the number? The number is 36. Okay, 36 means 36, whether it is divisible by 4 or no, we'll check it. Yes. 4 nines is how much? 36. 36 comes in 4 table. Yes, that is 4 nines is 36. So here 36 is divisible by 4. Then the whole number, that is 1936, is also divisible by 4. If last two digit, that is 36, is not divisible, if it is not divisible by 4, then whole number will be not divisible by 4. But here 36 comes in 4 table. That means the 36 is divisible by 4. That is 4 nines is 36. So 1936 is also divisible by 4. The next number, the next example, that is the number is given 4 digit, 3516, that is 3516. So to check whether it is divisible by 4, we'll check the last two digit. The last two digit means that it is in ones place and tens place. In ones place it is 6 and tens place it is 1. The last digit is 16. So last digit is 16. So whether it is divisible by 4? Yes. 4 fours is 16. So here 16. So here 16 is divisible by 4. When it is divisible by 4, last two digit, then whole number, that is 3516, is also divisible by 4. Okay, children. This was a divisibility. This is divisibility. This is test of divisibility. Okay, this is the first one is divisibility by 2. The next is divisibility by 4. Then afterwards, it is divisibility by 4. So next we'll go to the next divisibility 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 in the next video part. So practice this example and solve it. Okay, children, we'll continue this unit in the next video. Thank you.